Today I'm going to talk about the active temperature-controlled heater I use to heat my Prusa XL enclosure. Welcome to Barrett Works. Okay, so it is an AC Infinity Thermoforge T3, and AC Infinity produces a lot of equipment for grow tents, grow operations, I guess, and also HVAC equipment. Years ago, I bought their high-tech PWM-controlled, very modern fans as boosters in the heating and cooling system in this house. They've worked very well. I also use AC Infinity fans to just blow air around in some rooms, and it's an AC Infinity fan that is drawing air out of the exhaust on the printer. So once I became familiar with their technology and they've continued to evolve, I'm finding more and more of their devices that have served a useful purpose for me. So let's talk about this heater. It lives down on the bottom shelf on the printer stand and is plugged in with a wired connection to this remote control. When the remote control is connected, the display screen on the printer goes blank, and only this is the control. And it's also plugged into power, of course. The controller has a set of buttons at the bottom. This one here moves through modes. There's something like 7 or 8 modes. And then the display is the current temperature that's being read from inside the enclosure. The temperature probe is there at the back. It's that silver sensor. It senses both temperature and humidity. And I've just put it in pretty informally on that back ledge. That ledge is there because this is a two-head Prusa XL. So it gives me a space both to mount my time-lapse camera and to put that probe. I've also put a light back there. So I'm making good use of that ledge. This controller is, you can hang it on the wall with screws. It's also got magnets built in. And so when I made this piece to mount it on, I embedded magnets in it. And so the whole thing just snaps into place, which is pretty cool. One wire is the wired connection to the probe. This is the wired connection to the heating device. And then this is a new device from AC Infinity. It's a Wi-Fi dongle, which there's a paired second dongle that goes with it. And so the fan, the exhaust fan, that is also controlled from this controller, I no longer need to have a physical wire running to it. So this is a mobile printer. It's on a cart with wheels. It moves quite a bit. I no longer have the wire to the fan. I only have the power cable. The other thing that this controller does is it connects to my Wi-Fi network and allows me to do all of this control also from my phone. And so I control a variety of devices in the house. Some are the HVAC devices that I already mentioned, but then I can use these displays to change the target temperature, turn the heater on, turn the fan on, to control the fan that's the exhaust for the system, all from the phone. So I don't actually interact with this controller directly very often. Let me disconnect it and show you the heater proper. Now first, this right here, and I'm gonna pull the heat feed hose out. It's just the interference fit. This is the duct that I designed to dump air into the printer. Now, when I originally was designing this, I created a version that is a large plenum. My goal was to slow down the air that's coming out the end of this exhaust hose and spread it out into a large internal volume at the bottom of the heater. And then it had 400 holes. The idea being to put air gently into this and not create a small hurricane inside the box. In the end, I realized that was not necessary and I went with a simpler duct. Most of the prints happen well above where this gets dumped into the printer, and there's the heat plate in between. If I ever have large enough prints that they've come all the way down and this is blowing directly on them, they'll be blowing on the initial part of the print. Printhead will be working way at the top. So I don't think this will affect the cooling behavior of the filament as it's going down on the print. We'll find out. I'll go back to that big plenum if I need to. For now, this has been working well. So the hose is this plastic hose, which you've probably run into in one device or another. And it comes with an extra extension. So you can see it holds its positioning. So you could run this to some point where it was just positioned to blow into some device rather than having to be actually mounted. They say the extension is 4 feet. I haven't actually measured it because I don't use it. Where this is placed, the built-in hose reaches. So I'm going to disconnect the wire to the controller, unplug power, and we'll pull it out. So The first thing that I'll mention is that it's very light. This is not a heavy device. This is the display screen that is active when you don't have it plugged into an external controller. And this is the intake. The cable coils in the bottom, and they've got nice indentations to hold the power cable in place so that it doesn't sit on it when it's on the table. That's about it. There's not a lot physically to the device. The technologies inside are pretty cool. So it produces heat with three ceramic PTC plates, positive temperature coefficient. You may have heard of those. Some of the small heaters that people are adding to 3D printers, and they usually look like a little box, and I think they may originate in the automotive industry, are also PTC. What that means is that the material that is being used to produce the heat doesn't have to be a ceramic plate, but it's being described by positive temperature coefficient, meaning as the temperature in the plate rises, temperature in the material that's producing the heat, as you put current through it and the temperature rises, at some point the resistance increases dramatically in the case of the plates used in this. So you put a current through the plate heats up. When it reaches a certain temperature, it greatly increases the resistance, the character of this material. It's not electronics making that happen, just the character of the material. At that point, the current drops like crazy and the plate quits heating. So at the high end, they're self-regulating, which is a great safety feature. With the three plates and pulse width modulation, PWM, which is the other cool technology these use, they have the ability to create what they claim are 10 distinct heat levels. Let me say that differently. The controller has 10 levels. But it's, I think, a fairly consistent progression of temperature. I wanted to test both the maximum temperature that it actually achieves and how much change there is at each of these 10 levels on the controller. So we set this up on the table and I ran this test. What I found is that at the high end, once you got up to level 8, 9, and 10, that the actual air temperature coming out the end of the exhaust was above the maximum temperature that the company said the heater could achieve. They say 60 degrees Celsius, which is 140 degrees Fahrenheit, but here we are above that in the 150s, close to 160. So it achieves the advertised maximum temperature. It gives you this very fine degree of control with levels 0, where it's off, all the way through 10. And it was, in fact, varying the temperature all the way up that scale. Hi, it's me from the future. Of course, those levels are really just set up. You're setting how hot the air is coming out the end of the nozzle. It's the target temperature you set in the enclosure that's going to control the temperature in the enclosure. The controller will turn the heater on and off, just like your furnace goes on and off, to maintain the temperature you've set. Obviously, if you set higher temperatures, you need higher levels, maybe level 10. You might always run it at level 10, and it will cycle the heater on and off as it needs. Okay, back to the present. So, that's great. I knew from just use that that seemed to be what they promised. Thought it would make sense to actually measure it. Also, while I ran this test, we have these measurements of the power that it was drawing. At maximum, this is a 500-watt device. Think about the space heaters that you use in the house. They usually come with two settings, 800 watts or 1400 watts. This at maximum is 500 watts. When you use it in heating mode, there's only one fan setting. This is one of its drawbacks, which is full on. It dumps out a lot of heat, and it never draws more than a little bit over 500 watts. So, very efficient way to produce heat. As a matter of fact, if we ever need to run a space heater in the house and we're not using the printer, I might disconnect it and use this instead. So, PTC, three plates, 10 temperature levels, maximum temperature of 60 degrees Celsius. Actually, it goes a bit beyond it. And the PWM, pulse width modulation control. What does that mean? It means that instead of varying the voltage, it is sending pulses of full voltage power. So the device is always receiving the voltage it expects, the best voltage for that device, whether it's the heating plates or whether it's the fan inside there. But it's being controlled by sending quick little pulses. And by varying the length of those pulses, the amount of time in a set unit of time during which the full voltage is being applied in these pulses, you get different fan speeds or you get different degrees of heating in the plate. I thought it'd be fun to do a little test. So I hooked up a regular household fan to an extension cord I had that has a potentiometer in it. So with this slider, it varies the voltage. And so this fan draws about 50 watts full on. Bring the potentiometer down to about halfway, 20 some watts, and you can see from the little ribbon that, let's say, the fan is blowing about half as hard. So can I simulate pulse width modulation with a mechanical switch? Turn everything on full, and then rotate the switch rapidly. And I played around with trying to make it be a quick on, or just going back and forth very quickly, on, off, on, off, on, off, and managed to achieve what my kilowatt read as roughly 20 watts instead of the full 50, and what looked to be about half strength on the fan. So that was me with my fingers simulating pulse width modulation. Obviously, these devices with digital control do a much better job, and it's a much faster cycle, I believe. The fans that AC Infinity produce remain whisper quiet. They go down to a very slow speed. You don't get that kind of groaning that the electric motor does when you're sending it low voltage. It doesn't stall out at the slow speeds. I love it. So I've been using PWM fans in the HVAC system in this house for 5 years. Now I use them both just for cooling a room and for running the exhaust on this and in this heater. I'll include links in the description to the specification pages, the product pages at AC Infinity. Go take a look if you're interested. They've got a lot more information. Please subscribe. Help us continue to get this channel off the ground as we are just starting. And that's it. I'm going to put this back on the cart and get back to using it. Thanks for watching.